Dear students, greetings for the day. In this class today, we shall learn about surface tension and about viscosity in the properties of matter chapter. Surface tension is a property of the free surface of a liquid. The free surface of the liquid acts like a thin stretched elastic membrane and has a tendency to acquire a minimum surface area. When a drop of mercury is pressed a little with a needle, a dimple is formed at the point of contact and this dimple disappears as soon as the needle is removed. That implies the mercury drop behaves like a flattened rubber balloon. This means that the liquid surface behaves as a stretched membrane. The property by which the free surface of liquid acts as a stretched membrane having minimum surface area is called surface tension. Surface tension is also defined in another way. The normal force acting per unit length of imaginary line drawn on the surface of a liquid which tends to pull the surface along the line is defined as the surface tension of the liquid. Examples of surface tension. Some insects are capable of walking on the surface of water due to surface tension. The surface tension. Another example is the surface of the stagnant water serves as a breeding place for the mosquitoes because of surface tension. A needle floats when it is gently placed horizontally on the surface of water in a beaker. This is due to surface tension. Raindrops are spherical in shape due to surface tension. For a given volume, the surface area is minimum for a sphere. Moreover, the cohesive forces of attraction among the molecules gives a spherical shape to a falling raindrop. Drops of water on certain leaves are spherical. When water is sprinkled on a greasy surface, the water forms as a cluster of small spheres. So, due to surface tension, raindrops are spherical in shape. When paint brush is dipped in water, the hairs of the brush separate in various directions and when it is taken out, they cling together due to surface tension. This is also a tension parallel to the surface at the liquid air interface, which will resist all external and external force due to cohesive nature of water molecules. The forces of attraction acting between the molecules of the same type are called cohesive forces, while those acting between the molecules of different types are called adhesive forces. So the forces of attraction between the molecules of the same type of substances are known as cohesive attraction forces, and the force of attraction acting between the molecules of different types of substances are known as adhesive force, attraction forces. The balance between cohesion of the liquid and its adhesion to the material of the container determines the degree of wetting, the contact angle, and the shape of meniscus. When cohesion dominates, that is specifically adhesion energy is less than half of cohesion energy, the wetting is low and the meniscus is convex at the vertical wall as per mercury in a glass container. On the other hand, when the adhesion dominates, adhesion energy is more than half of cohesion energy, the wetting is high and similar meniscus is concave as in water in a glass. Surface tension is responsible for the shape of liquid droplets. Although easily deformed, droplets of water tend to be pulled into a spherical shape by the imbalance in cohesive forces of the surface layer. In the absence of other forces, drops of virtually all liquids would be approximately spherical. The spherical shape minimizes the necessary wall tension of the surface layer according to Laplace's law. Another way to view surface tension is in terms of energy. A molecule in contact with a neighbor is in a higher state of energy than if it were alone with same from contact with a neighbor. The interior molecules have as many neighbors as they can possibly have, but the boundary molecules are missing neighbors compared to interior molecules and therefore have higher energy. For the liquid, to minimize its energy state, the number of higher energy boundary molecules must be minimized. The minimized number of boundary molecules results in a minimal surface area. As a result of surface area minimization, the surface will assume the smoothest shape it can. Mathematical proof that smooth shapes minimize surface area and relies on use of the Euler-Lagrange equation. Since any curvature in the surface shape results in greater area, a higher energy will also result. Effects of surface tension. Water. Several effects of surface tension can be seen with ordinary water. A beading of rainwater on a waxy surface such as leaf. Water adheres weakly to wax and strongly to itself, so water clusters into drops. Surface tension gives them nearly spherical shape because a sphere has the smallest possible surface area to volume ratio. The formation of drops occurs when the mass of liquid is stretched. The animation below shows water adhering to the surface, gaining mass until it is stretched to a point where the surface tension can no longer keep the drop linked to the facet. It then separates and in surface tension forms the drop into a sphere. If a stream of water were running from the facet, the stream would break up into drops during its fall. Gravity stretches the stream, then surface tension pinches it into sphere. Flotation of objects denser than water occurs when the object is non-weightable and its weight is small enough to be borne by the surfaces arising from the surface tension. For example, water striders use surface tension to walk on the surface of a pond in the following way. The non-weightability of the water striders means there is no attraction between the molecules of the leg and molecules of the water. So when the leg pushes down on the water, the surface tension of the water only tries to recover its flatness from its deformation due to the leg. The separation of oil and water, in this case water and liquid wax, is caused by a tension in the surface between dissimilar liquids. This type of surface tension is called interface tension, but its chemistry is the same. Tears of wine is the formation of drops and rivulets on the side of a glass containing an alcoholic beverage. It causes a complex interaction between the differing surface tensions of water and ethanol. It is induced by a combination of surface tension modification of water by ethanol together with ethanol evaporating faster than water. Units of surface tension. A surface tension is nothing but the force acting per unit length and the liquid surface drawn on the imaginary line. So surface tension is equal to force by length, therefore Newton per meter is SI unit. dimensional formula for surface tension is obtained by dividing force with the length MLT to the power of minus 2 by L. Therefore, dimensional formula is MT to the power minus 2 or ML to the power 0 T to the power minus 2. Explanation of surface tension with reference to molecular theory. The property of surface tension is due to the intermolecular force of attraction of the liquid. The molecules of a liquid exert force of attraction among themselves as a solid surface with which they are in contact. Cohesive force. The force of attraction between the molecules of the same substance is called cohesive force. Example, attraction between the water molecules and attraction between the oil molecules. Adhesive force. The force of attraction between the molecules of different substances is called adhesive force. That is attraction between the paper and gum, attraction between fevicol and plywood, attraction between water drop and glass container. Molecular range. The maximum distance from the center of the molecule up to which the molecule exerts a force of attraction is called molecular range. The molecular range is very small, of the order of 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter. Sphere of influence. The imaginary sphere with molecule is the center and molecular range as radius is called sphere of influence. One molecule attracts another molecule within the sphere of influence. So here we consider three molecules, which are A is which is inside the water, and B is at the surface of the liquid, and C is half part of sphere of influence is half of the part is outside and half of the part is inside. So inside molecules attract the B and C molecules. So upper surface is trying to possess minimum area. The phenomena of surface tension of liquids may be explained on the basis of molecular theory. The molecules deep below the surface of the liquid are attracted symmetrically by the surrounding molecules, and the resultant cohesive force on them is zero. The molecules near the surface experiences a resultant cohesive force in the downward direction because less number of molecules over their level in the liquid. The molecules on the surface experience a maximum resultant force in the downward direction as there will be no liquid molecules above the surface of the liquid. Hence, all the molecules in the surface film experiences a maximum resultant downward force. Therefore, the entire liquid surface is pulled downwards. The molecules in the surface film possess greater potential energy than those inside the liquid. The potential energy of a system should be minimum for stability. So the surface film tries to have minimum possible area with minimum number of molecules. Therefore, the surface of the liquid contracts and behaves like a stretched membrane. This property of free surface of the liquid is called surface tension. Let A be the free surface of the liquid. Consider three molecules, ABC or PQR, let us name like that, which are shown in the figure. The three circles in the liquid indicates the spheres of the sphere of influence of the molecule PQR. A molecule attracts and attracted by the molecules in its sphere of influence. The molecule P is deep below the liquid surface and is attracted symmetrically by the molecules in all directions. Hence, the resultant cohesive force on it is zero. The molecule Q is near the surface and its sphere of influence is partially above the surface. There will be no liquid molecules above the surface. So the number of liquid molecules are less in the upper hemisphere than those in lower hemisphere of sphere of influence of Q. Hence, the molecule Q experiences a resultant cohesive force in the downward direction. Sphere of influence of the Q. Hence, the molecule Q experiences the resultant cohesive force in the downward direction. The molecule R is on the surface of the liquid. There will be no liquid molecules in the upper hemisphere. Therefore, the molecules in the lower hemisphere attract the molecule R, and it experiences a maximum resultant force in the downward direction. Consider a plane CD which is parallel to the surface AB of the liquid at a distance equal to the molecular range of attraction. The layer of liquid between these two planes AB and CD is called the surface film. All the molecules in the surface film experiences a maximum resultant downward force. Therefore, it is concluded that the entire liquid surface is pulled downward due to the forces of attraction of the molecules. If a molecule is to be brought from the interior of the liquid to the surface, some work is to be done against the downward cohesive force acting on it. This implies that the molecules in the surface film possess greater potential energy than those inside the liquid. The potential energy of the system should be minimum for stability its revolution. So the surface film tries to have minimum possible area with minimum number of molecules. Therefore, the surface of the liquid contracts and behaves like a stretched membrane. Thus, the molecular theory successfully explains the phenomena of surface tension. Let us know about what is angle of contact. When the free surface of a liquid meets a solid, they two intersect at a definite angle, which depends on the nature of the liquid and of the solid. Consider a glass beaker containing water. Suppose that a glass plate is dipped vertically in the water, then the water rises up a little at the sides of the glass plate as shown in the figure. The contact angle is the angle conventionally measured through the liquid where a liquid vapor interface meets a solid surface. It quantifies the wettability of a solid surface by a liquid via the Young equation. A given system of solid, liquid and vapor at a given temperature and pressure has a unique equilibrium contact angle. However, in practice, the dynamic phenomena of contact angle stiffness is often observed ranging from the advancing maximal contact angle to the receding minimal contact angle. The equilibrium contact is within those values and can be calculated from them. The equilibrium contact angle reflects the relative strength of the liquid, solid and vapor molecular interaction. So in these two beakers here, contact angle is explained. So when liquid surface here touches the glass rod, then the tangent drawn at the contact angle theta is known as contact angle. It is the angle between the surface of the glass rod and water contacting surface. When we take mercury in another bottle and when the glass rod is dipped in that, then the mercury shown as having convex shape and the angle is more than 90 degrees, that is nearly equal to 140 degrees contact angle theta equal to in the case of mercury, but for water nearly theta is equal to 0. Suppose that mercury is taken in another glass maker and a glass plate is dipped in it. A mercury is depressed a little at the side of the glass plate as shown in figure. If a tangent is drawn to the surface of the liquid at the point of contact with a solid, the angle between the liquid is called angle of contact. Another example is given for the angle of contact here also. So the angle of contact between the liquid and the solid is defined as the angle enclosed between the tangent to the liquid surface and the solid surface which is in contact with the liquid as shown in the figure A given. It is an acute angle when water is taken in beaker. The angle of contact varies between 0 to 180 degrees. For the liquids which make the surface of a solid such as water and glass, the angle of contact is acute, while those for liquids which do not wet the surface of the liquid such as mercury and glass, the angle of contact is acute. The angle of contact decreases with the addition of impurities, whereas it increases if the temperature is increased. So in the second figure, we take mercury and if it makes an angle theta grad is equal to 140 degrees when it is in contact with the beaker glass surface. So angle of contact is defined like this. The angle made in the liquid by the tangent of the surface of liquid with the solid surface at the point of contact is called angle of contact. The angle of contact may have any value between 0 degree and 180 degrees. For the most of the liquids with glass, it is less than 90 degrees. For glass and mercury, it is about 140 degrees. The angle of contact depends on the nature of solid and liquid. The angle of contact does not depend on the amount of inclination of the solid surface or in the liquid. Application. Hot water. Clothes can be washed more effectively with hot water. When water is heated, its surface tension decreases and also the angle of contact. If the angle of contact is low, then water penetrates easily deep into the fabric and cleans the dirt effectively. So, on heating the liquid, surface tension decreases and dust is easily removed from the cloth in hot water. Detergents. When we use detergents in washing or added surf detergent to the water, then angle of contact reduces and also surface tension decreases. So washing is effective because dirt is easily removed from the cloth. Next, using of wetting agents. In dyeing, the wetting agents added to the color solution reduces their angle of contact and hence surface tension decreases and so dyeing will be effective. Using of waterproofing agents. Wax like substances are used as waterproofing agents. When these are added to water, the angle of contact increases and wetting does not take place. Let us know what is capillarity. A glass tube with a fine and uniform bore as its center is called capillary tube. When a capillary tube is dipped vertically into a liquid like water in a beaker, the liquid rises into the tube above the outside liquid level as shown in the figure. All liquids whose angle of contact is less than 90 exhibits the same effect in a capillary tube. The reason for this is that the adhesive forces between the water and the glass molecules are much greater than the cohesive forces between the water molecules. But when we take mercury in another beaker and when we put the capillary tube inside it, then mercury level is depressed in that one, because angle of contact is nearly 140. So this rise or depression the capillary tube liquid levels is known as capillarity. So in contrast, as shown in the figure, the liquid like mercury whose angle of contact is greater than 90 show a depression in capillary tube below outside liquid level when dipped into it, if as shown in figure. The reason for this is that cohesive forces between the mercury molecules are much greater than the adhesive force between the glass and mercury molecules. Therefore, surface capillarity is defined like this. The phenomena of rise or depression of a liquid near capillary tube due to surface tension is called capillarity. In a wax candle, molten wax rises up thick by capillary action. In plants, water and sap rises into the stem and leaves by capillary action. In a kerosene lamp, kerosene rises to the top of the wick through a narrow spaces between the threads of a wick by capillary action. When a blotting paper is kept on an ink drop, the ink rises up in the paper through the pores by capillary action. By plowing the agriculture land, capillary system between the grains of soil is destroyed and the unnecessary evaporation of moisture is prevented. So let us know the formula for surface tension basing on capillarity. So when we take liquid like water and when we put the capillary tube, liquid level rises over the capillary tube as shown in the figure. So here angle of contact let it be theta. And the upward force is P cos theta. Let us describe the work again, the forces acting on the molecules. A glass capillary tube of bore radius r is tipped vertically in a beaker containing a liquid of density d. Let h be the capillary rise, the meniscus is concave, let theta be the angle of contact of liquid with glass. The force due to surface tension T acts into the liquid along the tangent to the meniscus at the point of contact in the capillary bore. Consequently, the wall of the capillary tube exerts an equal and opposite force outwards. The vertical component of this force is T cos theta. And this component of force acts on the entire circular surface of the liquid in a capillary bore whose circumference is 2 pi r. The total upward force is circumference into force 2 pi r into T cos theta or 2 pi r T cos theta. Due to this upward force, the liquid rises in the capillary tube. The liquid rises until its weight balance upward force. If m is the mass and v is the wall in a capillary bore, then the weight of the liquid in capillary bore is equal to mg, that equal to vdg, since v equal to m by v, that equal to pi r square h into dg, since v equal to pi r square h. At the equilibrium position, upward and downward forces are same. Therefore, 2 pi r cos theta is equal to pi r square h dg, or T equal to hr dg by 2 cos theta. So this is the general formula for surface tension, T equal to hr dg by 2 cos theta. But for water, theta is equal to 0. Therefore, cos theta is equal to 1. Therefore, surface tension of water is equal to hr dg by 2, since cos theta is equal to 1. If the surface of the liquid in the capillary tube is convex, then the volume of the liquid in the capillary tube will be pi r square 3 h plus pi r cube by 3, that equal to pi r square h into h plus r by 3. Because of this correction, h is to be altered as h plus r by 3 in the above equation. Therefore, surface tension of the other liquid other than water is half which is plus r by 3 into r dt. Now the experiment for finding the surface tension of the given liquid, for example water, we take the water in this beaker and then we arrange the capillary tube like this. Then the water level rises in the capillary tube and compare it to the beaker in water, and that rises the h and capillary bore radius like it be r, and then the readings are noted in the table. So description: take a clean and dry capillary tube of radius r and it is arranged to dip in the liquid of a glass beaker with the help of a retort stand as shown in figure. The liquid level rises into the capillary tube. Capillary tube is adjusted such that the tip of wire just touches the water surface in beaker. To find the height of the liquid level in capillary tube over the surface of the liquid in beaker, focus the microscope on the lower meniscus of the liquid and note the reading R1. Later, focus the microscope horizontal crosswise with the tip of the wire which touches the water surface and note the reading R2. Therefore, height of the liquid is equal to h equal to R1 minus R2. Find the radius R of the capillary tube by using vertical crosswire of the traveling microscope, measuring the diameter of capillary tube D equal to R4 minus R3. If D is the density of the liquid in the capillary tube and G is the acceleration due to gravity at that place and theta is the angle of contact and H is the capillary rise, then surface tension of the liquid T is determined by using the formula T equal to H plus R by 3 into R dG by 2 cos theta, which is nearly equal to HR dG by 2 in the case of water, where H equal to height of the liquid, R equal to radius of the capillary tube, D equal to density of the liquid, and G equal to acceleration due to gravity. This is the experiment for finding the surface tension of the given liquid in the laboratory. Now let us now learn about the viscosity, concept of viscosity. A fluid is one which flows. All the gases and liquids are called fluids because they are flowing. Viscosity is one of the properties of fluids which offers resistance to their flow. It is analogous to friction between the two solids. The internal resistive forces present between the different layers of fluid, and this property is known as viscosity. Some liquids like water, kerosene, spirit, petrol, etc. flow more freely than coconut oil, groundnut oil, castor oil, etc. That means the viscosity of greasy oils is greater. A fluid flows due to the difference of pressure. Consider a liquid flowing on a horizontal surface. If we imagine the flow in different horizontal layers, one over the other, the velocity of upper layer is maximum, that of the lower level is minimum. Because of this fact, we fall backwards when we try to stand at the center of the stream in a direction opposite to flow. Each layer exerts some backward dragging force on its adjacent layer above it. The force of the upper layer tends to accelerate the lower layer next to it, whereas the lower layer tends to retard the motion of the upper layer. Therefore, there are two forces acting on adjacent layers tends to destroy the relative motion of the two layers. When a liquid flows slow and steady through a pipe, the central layer moves with maximum velocity, whereas the layer in contact if the wall of the pipe is practically stationary. The intermediate layers from the wall of the pipe to axis force with increasing velocity. Laminar flow or streamlined flow. The type of fluid in which the fluid travels smoothly and in regular paths is called laminar flow, which is sometimes called streamlined flow. The velocity, pressure, and other flow properties, each point in the liquid remains constant in laminar flow. The fluid in contact with the horizontal surface is stationary, but all the other layers slide over each other. Energy, a pack of new playing cards may be considered as an example of imaging laminate, thin layers in a laminar flow. Turbulent flow. The type of fluid flow in which the motion at any point varies rapidly in direction and magnitude is called turbulent flow. Turbulent flow is a type of fluid, gas or liquid, flow in which the fluid undergoes irregular fluctuations or mixing, in contrast to laminar flow, in which the fluid moves in smooth paths and or layers. In turbulent flow, the speed of the fluid at a point is continuously undergoing changes in both magnitude and direction. Critical velocity. The minimum velocity at which flow change from laminar to turbulent state is called critical velocity of the liquid. It varies from liquid to liquid and has higher values for highly viscous liquids. So in laminar flow, the layers are flowing parallel when compared to other layers. But in turbulent flow, at some points they are like parallel, and at some points they are distance between them is changing. So thickness is here. No, and other they are moving irregularly at narrow levels. In turbulent flow, their velocity changes, and the direction also, motion also changes. Velocity gradient. The variation of velocity with the transverse distance is called velocity gradient. In a laminar flow, the velocity of a liquid at any point in the horizontal layer is same, but the velocity of liquid in the layer perpendicular to the direction of flow is different, and it decreases with increase in depth. Hence, there is velocity gradient perpendicular to the flow of fluid. Let us know about viscous force. The tangential backward dragging force that comes into play between two adjacent layers of liquid and tends to oppose the relative motion between them is called viscous force or viscous drag. Let us know the definition of viscosity. The property of liquid which gives rise to viscous force that tends to oppose the relative motion between its layers is called viscosity. Let us know the examples for viscosity. The tides of water are subsided due to viscosity of water. Raindrops are slowed due to viscosity of air. Proper viscosity of blood keeps our cardiovascular system well. Hydraulic brakes are operated by proper viscosity of the brake fluid. Many cosmetic gels and lotions, example suntan lotion, could not be spread across the skin if it were not viscous. The viscosity of a paint enables us to coat the buildings. Honey runs slower than water because of high viscosity. Molten glass is extremely viscous and approaches infinite viscosity as it solidifies. Now let us derive the Newton's formula for viscous force. Newton was the first person to study the factors that govern viscous forces in a liquid. Consider two adjacent layers P and Q having equal areas and separated by a distance dx in the laminar flow of a liquid as shown in the figure. So upper layers moving with higher velocities V plus dV, whereas the lower level moves with velocity V. These two layers are separated by distance dx. Dx is the distance between the layers, and actually the lower level distance from the bottom of the bottom surface of the liquid flow is x, and the upper layer is at a distance x plus dx from the distance. According to Newton's law of viscous flow, the magnitude of the viscous force F on a certain layer of liquid is proportional to the area of the liquid A and the velocity gradient dv by dx, which is perpendicular to the direction of flow. Therefore, F is proportional to A and F is proportional to dv by dx. Therefore, it may be written as F is proportional to A into dv by dx, or F equal to proportionality constant zeta into A into dv by dx, where zeta is constant of proportionality and is known as coefficient of viscosity. It depends on the nature of the liquid. The viscous force always acts in opposite direction to the flow of the liquid. Therefore, dv by dx is negative. Newton's formula for viscous force, F equal to zeta into A into dv by dx, or coefficient of viscosity, zeta equal to F by A into dv by dx. If A equal to 1, velocity gradient dv by dx equal to 1, then coefficient of viscosity is equal to the force. Therefore, viscous force acting per unit area when there is unit velocity gradient in the flow of the liquid is called coefficient of viscosity. This is also known as coefficient of dynamic viscosity. SI unit for coefficient of viscosity from the equation, coefficient of viscosity is equal to F by A into dV by dx. Therefore, SI unit is obtained as Newton per meter square into meter per second into meter per minus 1, that is Newton second per meter square. Dimensional formula for coefficient of viscosity is obtained from the formula coefficient of viscosity is equal to F by A into dV by dx. So finally, substituting the dimensional formula for force and area and dv and dx in the equation, here we obtain finally dimensional formula as m to the power 1, l to the power minus 1, t to the power minus 1. Therefore, the dimensional formula for coefficient of viscosity is written as m l to the power minus 1, t to the power minus 1 inside the bracket. Now let us know the effect of temperature on viscosity of liquids and gases. For liquids, the cohesive forces between the molecules are responsible for the viscosity in liquids. As the temperature increases, the distance between the molecules increases, hence the cohesive forces decreases. So viscosity of the liquid decreases as the temperature increases. For gases, the cohesive forces in gases are very small due to the collisions among the molecules. The momentum is transferred from the molecules of higher velocity in one layer to the molecular of the lower velocity in another layer. So this exchange of momentum is responsible for the viscosity in gases. As the temperature increases, the exchange of momentum increases. As a result, the viscosity also increases with the increase in temperature. So we may say that viscosity of gases increases as the temperature increases. Poiseuille equation for coefficient of viscosity. Poiseuille deduced an expression to determine the coefficient of viscosity of low viscous liquids like water by measuring the rate of flow through a capillary tube uniform bore. Consider a liquid flowing through a capillary tube under a small pressure difference, which is just sufficient to overcome the viscous force in the flow. Then the velocity of the liquid is maximum along the axis of the capillary tube, and velocity of the layer of the liquid in contact with walls of the tube is zero. The coefficient of viscosity of the liquid flowing through the capillary tube is given by coefficient of viscosity equal to pi into pressure P into radius of the capillary tube R to the power 4 by 8 into L into V, where P is the pressure difference between the ends of the capillary tube, R equal to radius of the capillary bore, L equal to length of the capillary tube, and V equal to volume of the liquid flowing per unit time through the capillary tube. Now let us know about the experiment for determining the coefficient of viscosity of the liquid by using Poiseuille formula. Poiseuille determined the coefficient of viscosity beta of less viscous liquids by making liquids to flow through a capillary tube and by measuring the rate of the flow. He derived at the following expression, coefficient of viscosity theta equal to pi p r to the power of 4 by 8 v into L. So let us how experimentally determine the coefficient of viscosity. So take the liquid in the glass vessel as shown in the figure and put the capillary tube through the cork, and when the liquid is allowed to fall through the capillary tube of radius R, and if H is the increase of the level, and the collected water in the given time, let its volume or mass is measured. So let a capillary tube of length L and radius R is fitted in the bottom of the aspiratory glass bottle by means of a rubber cork. Take liquid in the bottle, keep the beaker at the end of the capillary tube, and collect the liquid in it for the time t. Let m be the mass of the liquid in time t collected in the bottle. The volume of the liquid collected in 1 second, V equal to m by d into t. The average height of the liquid column h equal to h1 difference h2 by 2. Let g be the acceleration due to gravity. Pressure difference between the two ends of the capillary tube, P equal to hvg. Then j coefficient of viscosity is found by using the Poiseuille equation, pi into p into r to the power of 4 by 8 v into l. By substituting the values of p, r, v and l, we obtain the value of coefficient of viscosity. In this experiment, the following precautions are taken. Capillary tube must be clean and horizontal. Radius of the capillary tube should be measured accurately. Streamline flow. The flow of the fluid in which all the particles of the liquid move in the same path and with same velocity at a point within the liquid remains constant both in magnitude and direction is called streamline flow. In streamline flow, layers are traveling parallelly as shown in the figure. Critical velocity. The velocity of the liquid at which the streamline flow changes into turbulent flow is called critical velocity. This velocity changes from one liquid to another and depends upon the viscosity of the liquid. Reynolds number. If the rate of flow of liquid is very large, the flow is not in stream in the line of flow but becomes turbulent flow. As the flow is turbulent, the velocity of the liquid at any point in space changes rapidly and randomly with respect to time. Due to this, circular motion which are called also generated. The smoke rising from burning stack of food, water currents of ocean and fast moving fluid crossing an obstacle are turbulent. The waves in the air left by cars aeroplane. Osborne Reynolds studies the flow of fluids and concluded that turbulent flow is less in viscous fluids flowing at flow rate. He defined a dimensionless number whose value, given an approximate idea to know the flow of the liquid is turbulent or not. The number is called Reynolds number and is denoted by Re. So Reynolds number Re is given or find out by using the formula P into V into D by coefficient of viscosity, where P is the density of the flowing fluid, V is the speed of the fluid, D is the length or diameter of the pipe, and theta is the coefficient of viscosity of the fluid. Reynolds number is a dimensionless number, and its value remains same in all systems of units. For streamlined flow, Reynolds number is less than 1000. For turbulent flow, Reynolds number is greater than 2000. The flow is unsteady for Reynolds number when it is between 1000 and 2000. The concept of critical of Reynolds number RE is useful in designing ships, submarines, racing cars, and aeroplanes. When the fluid of density P moving with velocity V along the pipe of length D, area of cross section A, and viscosity of your fluid is theta, then the value of RE can be also expressed as RE equal to RV square by HV by V, or RAV square into HAV by V. Equation of continuity. Let a fluid flowing through a pipe of different cross section areas as shown in figure. The planes of cross section areas are perpendicular to the flow of fluid. Consider three planes at points PQR. The number of fluid particles crossing the surfaces PQR remains the same. The area of cross sections of these points are AP, AQ, AR respectively. The speeds of fluids of the particle at these points are VP, VQ, ER. The mass of fluid delta MP cross through the area of cross section AQ is interval in interval of time delta T is VQ into A into VQ into delta T. The mass of the fluid delta MR cross through the area of cross section AR is small interval of time delta T is rho R into AR into VR into delta T. Therefore, the mass of the fluid flows equal to mass of fluid flows outwards in all cases. Therefore, according to the equation of continuity, rho P into AP into VP into delta T equal to rho Q into AQ into VQ into delta T equal to rho R into AR into VR into delta T. For compressible fluids, rho P equal to rho Q equal to rho R. Therefore, AP VP equal to AQ VQ equal to AR VR. This equation is called equation of continuity expression, or AV equal to constant in general. So that means the mass of inflow of compressible fluid remains constant. So this is the equation of continuity. So now the chapter properties of matrix completed. So in this chapter we discussed about elasticity, surface tension, and viscosity. If you have any doubt, please contact me. Thank you.